Okay, so now I will make the last video in this session. So what kind of WebSocket messages are supported? I have already shown that the WebSocket messages, they are in the WebSocket messages folder. So here we have lots of examples. And the most important one is the sign and bundle uploads, sign and upload bundles message. So this is this one here. This one here. And this is the one that you have to create to do everything what you need for a normal prescription. And what the important thing is, you always have to create a new ID here. And therefore, what I will do is I will use one from the front end, and then I will show you with the Java backend how to send this message. And let's just do this. So let's get to the running front end, localhost front end. So let's take a simple one. Let's take this one here, and let's observe the WebSocket. Okay. Let's, yeah. What you can see here is that our front end is exactly sending this message. At the moment, this is connected to Titos. So this one is now signed, and this is the answer. And let's get now this JSON stuff. So let's copy this message, and let's encode the string so we can put it in a Java message. Encode Java string. Got a string to encode Java string. This is not UTF-8. Encode Java string online. Be on a java.sk. This is what I need. Green proceed. Escape. This is what I need. Okay. So here I have my test case. So then here I have my message. And this is now all JSON. And the important thing is this ID. So if we use this ID twice, we can't put it into Titus. So what I will do is I will generate a random UUID here. So random UUID, random dot to string. And I think this, I have to import this one here. And I think this is random UUID to string. And let's save. And now let's wait here a lot longer. And then let's see if this works. So this is the most important message that you need. Because what this is basically doing, it's creating the prescription. And actually it already worked. So this is now very fast because everything is set up. What you now get as a response. So when you send this message, the first response that you get, it's the HTML bundles response. So the HTML bundles response, this is the processed XSLT style sheet for this XML bundle. And you have to show this to the doctor so he can sign the bundle. So I will show you this. If you go to our system, this thing here, this is what you have to show to the doctor when he puts his EHBA on the card reader. Then it is necessary that the doctor sees this paper here. The next thing what you get is you get an e-reset with documents message, and this e-reset with documents message, it contains the access code. It contains the bundle. So the bundle it's nearly the same bundle that you sent. The only difference is the identifier. So we added this identifier, and that's new. And all the other things should be the same. But the identifier is important, and this is also the bundle that was signed by the doctor. So then let's see, and then what you also get is you get the PDF document as a base 64 encoded string. So let's try if I can decode this on the command line, just to give you an example. Vepdf.dat. So OpenSSL base 64, I think this is like this. Unrecognized flag input. Sorry, this was wrong. Sorry, I just destroyed the file. Just have to re-add the data. Okay, so this is it. And then e-prescription PDF. And then Evans. So at the moment it's not working. Let's see what the problem is. So for some reason this is just the last part here. Well, there should be a lot more. Don't know why base 64. Do we have just a base 64? Let's check out how this base 64 decode is. Base 64, base encode decode. So let's try again. Slash D. Okay, so this looks a lot better. Okay, so now this is also working. The reason why this did not work in the first one with OpenSSL might be that there are no new lines in the base 64 encoded data. But if you have a more robust base 64 decoder, you can decode this correctly, and then you can look into the e-prescription. So now this is how you send the most important message to us. Also, more about the details into this message will be in the next sessions. And now I will explain a little bit more about the other messages. And I will just explain this, so that there won't be any. I won't show you examples, but we can do examples in the next sessions. So there is the abort task message. The abort task message gives you the possibility to delete again e-prescription from the domain system from the Fachdienst. Also on the front end, if you click on these buttons here. These buttons, they will send abort messages. So I can show you this. So if you click here on delete, you can see here that an abort task message is sent, and then also you get an answer for the abort task message. It's called abort task status, and then you will see here that the deletion worked. So you get back a status okay. Then let's go back. So this were the abort messages. Then we have the activate comfort signature. So this is a message to activate the comfort signature. We have a message called all KBV examples. So this is a message where you can load examples into the front end. We have the deactivate comfort signature. We have the e-reset with documents that I have already shown, and we have the get signature response and then some settings messages. So I would just stop the video because I just have to go to the door for a minute.